a sweetheart. We raised her. Her and Mickey lived with us for her first 3 years, three or four years. She trusted people to a fault, and I guess that was her final doing.
Tonight we have breaking news. A teenager killed, her killer on the loose.
You have a body in the creek of Heritage Glen?
Yes, I have a little girl's body in the creek. Please, we reported her missing last night. We just found her.
That 911 call just released to us, and we've also just learned this 15-year-old victim was stabbed to death. Good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello.
And I'm Mike Dardis. The girl's death is hitting hard, as you can imagine, in Fairfield. Her body found about 2 miles from her home. News 5's Karen Johnson spoke with her grandfather. She joins us with the breaking details. Karen.
Well, Mike, I'm told Chelsea Johnson's family was searching for her along this creek last night when her mother's boyfriend discovered her body. This is right behind a vacant apartment building, and we just confirmed the 15-year-old had been stabbed to death.
She loved the fish. I taught her that. I used to take her fishing all the time. She loved the fish. She liked to camp. She loved to read. We brought her the Kindle for Christmas.
Phil Johnson's next gift to his granddaughter Chelsea was supposed to be a pickup truck for her sweet 16. He won't get that chance to surprise her.
I can't believe she's gone.
Chelsea's body was discovered down near the creek off Brookfield Drive yesterday evening, about a mile from her home on Southgate Boulevard. Phil says her cell phone had been tossed in the water. Chelsea's mother last saw her daughter around 11:30 Sunday morning. She reported Chelsea missing 22 hours later when messages weren't returned, and no one at Options Academy, where Chelsea was a freshman, knew where she was either.
It makes no sense. Makes no sense whatsoever. And I know that was a lot of what the kids were having. Those were the questions the kids were having, you know. They wanted to know, you know, what happened? How did this happen?
Today, counselors at Options dealt with questions and fears from the teen's classmates, while her family worries Chelsea's warm and trusting personality may have been what landed her in trouble.
She trusted people to a fault, and I guess that was her final doing.
And Fairfield police had been out here collecting evidence. At this point, no arrests have been made, and Fairfield police haven't named any suspects. They won't even say if they believe this was a random act or if the freshman from Fairfield was targeted. If you have any information that can help them, you're asked to call Crime Stoppers 352-3040. Reporting live tonight in Fairfield, Karen Johnson, News 5.
And Karen, I understand Chelsea's body was found not too far away from where Caitlin Markham was last seen. A lot of people have been asking the question, could there be a connection?
You know, you're right. A lot of people have been coming up asking us the question also. Caitlin Markham, she did live about a block from here on Dorshire. But at this point, Fairfield police are not giving any indication that the two cases are connected. But I am sure that is something they're looking at tonight. Mike.
All right, Karen, thank you very much.